iPhones and iOS devices in general have a lot of accessibility features like VoiceOver and Zoom and Magnifier and Voice Control and so much more. But it can be a real pain to have to go into settings and then go to accessibility, find the feature that you're looking for and then turn it on, especially if you're like me and you like to turn things on and off regularly. So let's talk about two and a half accessibility shortcuts that can make your life easier. Hi, I'm Carrie on Accessibility. If you're interested in assistive technology and accessibility in general, make sure you subscribe and hit the bell so you can be notified every time I upload a video. So let's just jump right in on the iPhone and how to set up those different shortcuts. And there's also a bonus shortcut at the end. So first you want to go to your settings and then you want to scroll down to accessibility. And you want to scroll all the way down in the accessibility menu until you get to accessibility shortcut. And that is the first shortcut we're going to talk about. So we're going to tap there, and here you will have a list of pretty much every accessibility feature that iOS has, and you can select the one that you want. And so how this works is if you triple press your side button, or if you still have one, your home button, it will turn on and off that accessibility feature. So right now I have VoiceOver set to the accessibility shortcut, and so if I triple press the side button here,
settings, accessibility, back button,
it turns VoiceOver on, and if I do it again,
VoiceOver off,
it says VoiceOver off. Now, if you select more than one features, which you can, and it's totally fine, what will happen is if you triple press that button, it will bring up a menu and you'll have to select which accessibility feature you want to turn on or off. And so for me, because I use VoiceOver, I want to have like that physical button to press to turn it on and off. I set it so that it's only VoiceOver, and so I don't have to fiddle with a menu. Before we go to shortcut two, one thing I don't mention in this video is assistive touch, which is another great accessibility shortcut, and I will be going over that in a separate video. Shortcut number two is back tap. And this one, you double tap or triple tap the back of your phone, and you can set that as an accessibility feature or a few other options as well. So what you want to do is you want to go back to your accessibility menu, and under physical and motor, you want to select touch. And so that's the first one in that section. And then you want to scroll down to the bottom and you will find back tap. When you tap on that, you'll have the two different options for double tap and triple tap. So let's go ahead and select double tap. And here you have lots of different options. You have app switcher, you have control center, home, lock screen, mute, and you can even control your volume up and down. And then there's a whole accessibility section, which doesn't seem to have as many features that you can set as the accessibility shortcut, but it's still great. It still has Zoom, VoiceOver, it has speak screen, invert colors, it has magnifier and assistive touch. And then if you go back, you can also do the same thing and set up your triple tap, and it has all the same options. I have my back tap set to magnifier and zoom, and if you're interested in learning more about magnifier and zoom, check out my other videos and make sure you're subscribed, because I'll be talking more about iOS and all its accessibility features. Shortcut number three, which is a half shortcut, is Siri. It's a half shortcut because it doesn't really work with all the different accessibility features. For example, it does not work with Zoom or Magnifier. So I can tell Siri, turn on Zoom.
I can't do that, but you can change it in settings.
So you still have to go into the settings, but if you do VoiceOver, it'll work. Turn on VoiceOver.
Okay, VoiceOver is now on.
So now,
settings, VoiceOver.
VoiceOver is on, and you can even use it to turn VoiceOver off. VoiceOver off.
Okay, I turned voiceover off.
So if you have a friend who has an iPhone and you're a voiceover user, you could potentially take their phone and use Siri to turn on voiceover. Which, I mean, obviously don't do that without their permission, but it is something that you can do. I have found that Siri can work with voiceover, and it can also work with inverting, with smart invert and with classic invert, as well as assistive touch. Now for the bonus shortcut, which is the control center, but it's not really even a half shortcut because there's only a few accessibility features that you can add to the control center. So if you go to settings and you go to control center, there's a few things that you can add. The first one is the accessibility shortcut. So what that does is it adds a new icon to your control center, and if you tap that icon, it will open a menu with the accessibility features that you have set up with the regular accessibility shortcut for triple pressing the home button or the side button. And so you can have that. The next one is dark mode, which you can technically turn on and off, and that could help with color contrast. The next one is hearing, and then there's also magnifier, which I do like to have on, and sound recognition if you're hard of hearing. And the next one is text size, and also I really like having voice memos in my control center. And that way you can have another kind of shortcut where it's just another swipe and tap away and you can launch that feature. So those are 2.5 plus a bonus accessibility shortcut for iPhone and iOS. If you're interested in learning more about assistive technology and accessibility in general, make sure to subscribe to this channel and hit the bell so you'll be notified every time I upload a video. And if you found this video helpful, hit that like button. And that's it for this video, and I will see you in the next one.